Strongest
Like,
skill in Grim Dawn.
Cadence, Kappa.
All right, if we're going to play it that way, Albrecht's Aether Ray.
I like how I've downloaded and installed Stripe, and I'm going to use it for probably an hour and a half at the tops. what rank is your flame touched?
5.
Okay.
We're gonna inspect Sino here.
Better inspect Wolf here. Ugh, purple's everywhere.
Strongest aura in the game.
You can answer that one. I'm not going there.
What? Escondra's? Flame touched and temper?
Flame touched is really good. Escondra's is also really good. Well, actually, do you consider Vindictive Flame an aura? Because it's
Oh, it's only self aura. Vindictive Flame might actually beat it out because of the total speed.
Yeah.
Okay, so I was doing a Battle Mage the other night. Someone asked about it in the chat, and the chat and I sort of theory-crafted up a Battle Mage. And part of the conversation about that was sort of a tier list in Grim Dawn for the classes.
Yeah.
And I know we'd done that before, but it's been a while since we've done that.
I don't even know what all the master classes are. Hold on, sir. Grim Calc.
Yeah, open right. Grim Calc. Look at thing on Grim Calc. Because I vote. Because, like, lately I've been saying there's only, like, an A tier and a B tier in the game because of the way the items are now. Let's start with the Hidden Lab, I guess.
Wait. What? Oh.
That's Zach.
I've gathered.
I'll throw a portal.
Abandon him.
I'll throw a portal down. I'll ban him, don't worry.
Oh, goodness me. Game is loud. Why are my sound effects maxed? Okay. It's been so long since I've heard Devastation. It kind of just ruined my ears.
Well, you have two people using it now. One of which does it twice. So, brace yourself.
Alright, I'm just gonna melee things. I'm helping. Alright, tier list.
Tier list. Go. So, yeah, I was thinking that it's like A tier and B tier. There's no real S tier, and there's no real tier below B. Because everything's pretty well equal right now. But, that being said, I think the Conjurer, Sorcerer, and Blademaster are all a step above the rest of the classes. But not by a huge degree.
I'm gonna respectfully disagree a little bit.
Okay.
Blademaster got a little shafted in the latest patch.
Okay.
Apparently it's no longer fun to play, according to the Blademaster aficionados. So, I'd put it in B tier, even.
Really?
Like, can't do anything. It's too much area of effect.
I mean, I'd offer to go switch off this character, but I'm hosting the game right now.
I would say Spellbreakers are probably a little bit above the rest as well because of the new Altramos legendaries.
Yeah, I can see that.
Really favor Shadow Strikes.
Yeah, I would have listed them in A tier as well.
Ah, yes, instanced.
Yeah, before we go in there, I'm going to turn your volume up just a little bit. Skype is maxed out already.
I guess I'm doomed to be quiet. I did something.
Oh, man. Well, now.
Why am I getting good shields? What is this?
Nice. Yeah, I would actually say, like what Anita said, that Druid would probably be A tier.
Yeah, I could buy that.
Border would be A tier.
Yep.
Well, I'm going to look around for Baldaren a bit. See if we can't find him.
I am down for that.
And we can also look for Benjar, too. That'll be a good, nice hour of streaming.
Your chat wants us to do Crucible. By the way.
Maybe later. And then I guess like B tier, you'd say B plus, B minus. And I was going to say, yeah, because it's not like there's a huge difference because B minus is just a battle mage. Because to me, I think it's it's the weakest.
Pretty much.
It's like the weakest class in the game, but you can still play it if you geared right and stuff. But I'd pretty much put everything else in B minus, like Elementalist, Pyromancer, Witch Hunter, Commando, Warlock, Sabo, Trickster. Because I actually think Grim Dawn is incredibly well balanced right now.
Yeah, it's actually in a pretty good state, just in time for the new Masteries to screw it all up.
Yep. Well, no, if anything, it's going to be the new Masteries are going to be crap initially.
Yeah, that'd be my guess.
Because that happened with the Arcanist and the Shaman when they both first came out.
Yeah. In response to something in your chat, Crucible is boring after 0 months.
I mean, I'm not a big Crucible person. I've mentioned it before that I don't like the mindless weapon swingy just...
Yeah.
Just
not really a fan.
Grind. Well, the thing about the Warlock is there are a lot of characters with sick DPS outputs. And for me, when I list tiers, I tend to take into account like build diversity, gear requirements, that sort of thing. So I would say gear dependency. So like one of the reasons the Battle Mage is so low is it's heavily gear dependent. And even then, that gear is not exactly great for a Battle Mage.
Agreed.
And you can get some sick damage output with a Battle Mage, but it requires pretty much being completely kitted out in legendaries. One of which is hard to craft for some people, being Baronath or Forged. And even then, like, compare that to a Sorcerer or a Conjurer. And the Sorcerer Conjurer is going to be far easier to gear. Oh, I found Benjar. Holy shit.
Wait.
I was looking for Valdarin in the Gates of the Necropolis, and I found Benjar. I opened the portal.
I'm in the middle of the conflagration, so I'm going to need a sec.
Okay.
Well, I could just die, maybe.
You could always do that. Hurry, because I got him half health. You're going to miss a Benjar fight.
It's fine, I never see him anyways. I'm here. I'm in a bad position.
Don't worry, we got him. Well, that was Benjar, everyone.
Glad I could see him for 2 seconds.
He exists. He's not a myth.
I don't know about that. Did you get anything from that? Because I got 2 legendaries from that.
I got nothing. I didn't even get his shoulders.
Oh, I got his shoulders too, but they were pretty crap.
I actually showed Windshear Greaves off earlier.
Tip the Scales is not a self buff. It targets one enemy. In Fighter chat.
Alrighty, so Benjar wasn't in his spot that spawns here. Valdarin wasn't in his spot that spawns there.
And he is not in the conflagration.
Okay. I'll run Rotting Croplands real quick.
Alright.
Get my amalgamation kill in there for today.
Can Valdarin show up in the Plains of Strife?
I don't know. We might have to run Volbury if he's not over here.
Yeah, I wasn't looking forward to that. I'm checking Burial Hill because he used to show up in here, but I don't know if he still does.
I don't have all the achievements. I'm missing all the hardcore ones and the Crucible ones.
Yeah, me too, pretty much.
Because I never do those things, because I don't like hardcore and not particularly a fan of the Crucible.
Yep.
Hey, Darlax. Hey, don't you slowly float away from me.
Oh, if he's not in the Rotting Croplands, it's looking like Valbury.
Yeah, I'm almost to the Grim Harvest. Well, I'm in the Grim Harvest. I mean, I'm almost to the Amalgamation. Hey, Gazini.
Is tip the scale is actually good. It's alright if you're... I would say it's just good. If you're a vitality build, it's better than good. But if you're not a vitality build, it's still good.
Yeah, he's not here.
Alright, I'm working toward robbery.
Okay. I'll just get my amalgamation killed and I'll be there. No pulsing shard. Okay, I'll meet up with you.
Alright. I'm at the rift, so I'll just drop a portal.
I like tip the scales too. Tip the scales is a good one.
Oh my goodness. I'm getting some great items today. I don't know about you.
Oh man. I know that's good even without even like without even looking at it. Yeah. That is a lot of health on that. Some good tanky shoulder pads. We're not getting hoarded by, I think it was 5 flesh hulks the last time I was in here on camera.
Sounds like fun.
It was not. Chat liked it though. That's what counts, really.
And these storms really like me. And you, apparently.
Oh, yeah. That's what happens when you read chat and not pay attention. Gloves for your character, Zach? You could go with really anything that gives you casting speed. I went all the way down instead of breaking that wall open.
Yeah, I was wondering, where the heck did you go?
Like I said, I'm reading chat. Yeah, Gazini, I'm probably going to pick up PoE when they release that expansion.
Path of Exile, dance game. I feel like I take more damage when I'm near you.
Well, you can't blame auras anymore for that. So much iron.
Yeah, that just gave me unusually high amounts of iron. Remember to throw residents, you know, a follow if you like what you see. He's lonely. No, I have the ethereal trace. There's a hero over here.
Hang on, I accidentally burned all my energy. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What's missing?
And another legendary. Oh, this isn't you. Saw the Maven's sphere and I thought it was just you.
Nope. I had to turn mine back on because I wasn't paying attention. Yeah, no, the Zackbot is very, very off-putting for pretty much everyone.
What?
Someone was like, you have a very strange bot in your chat. And I'm like, yeah, Zack is kind of a weird one.
Oh, a flash orb.
There he is.
There he isn't.
Was. There he was.
Yeah, thankfully this build does not have any issues with flesh orbs.
I was kind of thinking of pulling Canister Bomb back into this build. Specifically for them.
I'm not walking through there. I don't have mirror.
You don't have 3 seconds of invulnerability, that's totally balanced.
Balanced skill. Available without any investment into the master.
Shh. They'll hear you.
That guy was supposed to be tanky.
We killed him before we could get his flesh hulks out.
You're welcome. I take full responsibility for that.
Yeah, Vitality Conjurers are great. It's one of the reasons I put them so high on my tier list. Because I also kind of think Conjurers can run most of the builds that that combination offers.
How would you rate Commandos? Without basing the fact that I'm presently playing a Commando.
They're kind of a hard one to place. They're kind of B plus, A minus, maybe. They're in the middle. Like, vast middle tier. In my opinion. And that's basing on the fact I don't have one presently. Here, I'll go. Do you have a key or should I go make a key?
Yeah, I have a bit of a key.
Okay, then.
Whenever you're ready.
I'm ready. Now, where would you rate Commando in your experience?
I would say mid A tier. Oh, this is blocked. Oh, there's zombies down here. I would say mid A tier simply because they can be hard to gear up and stuff, but there's a lot of different ways to play them, which are pretty decent.
Yeah, that makes sense to me. Here, I'm gonna do one quick thing. We're gonna just tick the audio down on the game a little bit. Put my overall audio up a little bit. That way you should be louder.
I'm just gonna power through here, I think. Do you have absolute zero?
I do. I think it's only a couple points though. That should help you though. Yeah. I mean, oh yeah, you're doing cadence on Fire Strike.
Yeah. Every little bit helps when you do 100,000 damage.
it's at 6, so you're getting, so the physical res reduction is, that's full spread. No, wait, it is at 6. So, yeah, 22%.
Nice, I'll take it. Alright, I'm here.
Yeah, Commando, yeah, I would definitely say it can build pretty much everything in there.
Yeah.
Even if it takes a little gearing to do.
Masute. Retail is okay for two people. Kind of the issue with tanking is that it's very hard to draw enemy aggro.
Yeah. You have an ability that can do it. That's 3 Flesh Hulks.
Really? Because I count 4.
Oh, is there a 4th in here?
I believe so. Maybe.
Well, it's 3 now.
0 now.
Yeah. Been playing D3 since launch. It's nice to find a game that's confusing now. the game being confusing is Grim Dawn. Yeah, Grim Dawn does not hand you anything on a plate.
What are the odds that we get the instant Valderon? Aether Blaze, though.
Aether Blaze. It's so... Ooh. Uh-oh. I hear you going ooh-ooh, and you're tanky. Oh.
Very, very nice Stormlight entrance, bro. Man, I'm loving playing with you. I get all the loot.
Those are the Storm Titan treads you got. See, I actually think PoE is simpler than Grim Dawn.
I would agree, but every time you bring that up with Path of Exile players, they kind of just give you the stink eye.
Yeah, I know. But it's... The thing is, PoE, there's a lot in there, but you understand it.
Yeah.
At a glance.
Yeah.
Grim Dawn, there's a lot to the game, but it can be absolutely incomprehensible sometimes. Or there could be some aspect to the game that is like, oh, I didn't even know that existed. Like, I didn't know until earlier this week that you can convert internal trauma damage over to burns. If you're converting physical to out. Yeah, I didn't even know.
Yeah, there's still things, like, bits and pieces here and there that I learn every couple weeks. It's nice.
Yeah.
You just devastate one enemy.
That would probably be the proc off of my helmet. Hey, Aether Blaze again. Bye.
I know.
Bye. Aether.
About as long as last time.
Yep, Aether Blaze is so adorable. Especially when you're an Aether Ray guy.
Man, I hate those storms. Grim Dawn looks shit. What are you talking
what
about?
What the hell are you talking about?
This is probably the most beautiful looking ARPG on the market.
I would agree with that. Especially when you get all the settings jacked up like mine are.
Yeah. Oh, that's right, I'm not playing on the testing patch.
I mean, just look at the shadow work you get when you have everything jacked up. It's like just going in and out of this door. Like, that blew me away the first time I saw it with the settings jacked up. Oh, hello.
Suddenly, Ordis. I'm sure fight him on the Aether Drone. Oh boy.
Vigorous of Ruin.
I got literally nothing.
It's about time. Oh, did you mean look shit as in like the shit? As in the slang for it's actually good looking?
I make that mistake all the time.
Cause English is like that.
You have fun with that rage orb. I'm just gonna take this iron side orb. Oh, this is a hero.
I was wondering if that guy was in there because the sigil popped up underneath me. Well, I finally got a legendary we can look at. Woo. Handguards of Justice.
So can your character survive the flames of Albury, or is that a little dangerous?
I would assume so. we can do that like on our way to Hightown, I think.
Yeah.
Cause we can go and kill the guy in the north and still look for Valdaren.
I wonder if you could tether Valdaren into the Flames of Arbury.
Now, why would you think that?
Hey, I'm the person that tethered Valdaren into the Warden fight. Fought both of them at once.
That's fun. That's a little more reasonable, honestly.
Oh, I was targeting you for a while and wondering why I wasn't attacking.
No, I'm not that A3. Where would you rate the Saboteur?
Because
I know you've built one and played one for a while.
That's a good question. I would say a solid B. Not a B minus, not a B plus.
Okay.
I'm working on a Aether Saboteur, which is fun.
That's interesting.
But I'm not a huge fan of its performance.
Because I know you were working on a Vitality one, right? For that new, the new add-on to Anatomy of Murder?
That was in Cornucopia, but yes.
Oh, okay.
That one is amazingly fun.
Well, it's because it's in that great mod.
Yeah, of course, which everyone in your chat should totally go download.
Yeah, you should go check out the Cornucopia mod.
It's Mesmer. Why not?
This may be the first time I've experienced frame rate droppage.
Yeah, I was gonna say it got a little slow there for a moment. I wasn't sure if I was gonna live.
Okay, let me catch up with the chat while we're fighting an easy thing here.
Management. Do you need a Codex of Agrivix, by the way?
No. Right. Don't come near me, Storm.
Just running around you.
Just trying to pull that thing into me.
Yeah.
Yeah, vitality damage is really up there. Specifically for the Conjurer. Which is a class combo that I mentioned is in A tier. Probably A plus tier.
I could get behind that.
I'm ready. Alongside, like, the Sorcerer. And... See, I was thinking the Blademaster would be in there. Sino disagrees. Probably Blademaster people would disagree. But... I'm inclined to think it's there.
That fight is a lot easier on multiplayer.
Didn't get his thing.
Yeah, I got it. It's not great, but if you want it.
I think I have it. Well, I'll take it anyways. Put it in my stash. Use it for a transmute later. Transmog later. Tip the scales, it converts its damage to health. All the damage Tip the Scales does is it heals you.
For a new player, is Shaman and Soldier a good combo? It's probably the best combo for a new player, other than Conjurer.
Yeah. Warder is a really solid combination for...
Do you want to do the Flames or no?
Nah. We'll look for the Valdaren and the Merchant.
I spawned in to the sound of devastation.
welcome to gaming with me in Grim Dawn. I'm surprised I don't hear the sound. I'm surprised I don't hear the sound effect in my sleep. Unstoppable.
That hero and he went for
you. Yeah. Like, that guy's using Aether. How dare he? Alright, so I know that the merchant can spawn, like, in a weird middle place in here, and then down in the... in the south. Where's this third location? Is it to the east?
Yeah, it's to the northeast.
Okay.
Where are you going?
Alright. I know this place.
Actually, the real question is, where am I going?
Yeah.
Bet we get the fun spawn, but he's surrounded by like three other bosses.
Where he's gonna have like what's his name? Thelon? Yeah. Thelonian? Whoa, ow.
What an amazing support player I am. I just sat there reducing his damage. What an amazing player.
Couldn't have done it without you.
Yeah.
Because that devastation might have killed me.
Ooh, a heroic chest. With 3,000 iron.
Now, should we try to run this challenge room again, where I run in just blindly, and you stand outside war crying?
I mean, it worked pretty well last time. No complaints on my end. Well then.
Oh.
That was quite the challenge.
Man, that was skin of our teeth on that challenge room.
I don't know how we did it.
Yeah, I mean, we barely got out of there with our lives.
So yeah, speaking of the Northeast Trader, here he is.
Yeah, I kind of wish when I recorded the last time we co-opted that it actually came out. Because us, like, running into the Archon's room and there not being an Archon was really, really funny.
Yeah. That was a good session. Still shopping.
Man. None of these pulsing shards were good.
Take these components then.
Arcanion, the language on Tip the Scales is like that because that's just a language for Grim Dawn. So yeah, Tip the Scales. It says 100% of attack damage converted to health. That means 100% of the damage on Tip the Scales. So like for me, it deals 1, 2, 3, 5 vitality damage, and that would all be converted to health.
Yes, quite.
It doesn't mean 100% of all of your damage is converted. It's just the Tip the Scales damage.
So if Vaudovan isn't in here, what do we do?
That's actually a good question.
Yeah, Chip the Steals is a purple scroll.
Isn't it also like a, it's like the red circle bursts out for me, too.
Necromancer Mastery confirmed. What?
Yeah.
Oh, man, you lasered those Burning Deads just as I walked into them. I lost, like, 10,000 health.
Good. I'm glad I could help. Yeah, those death grips. They certainly exist.
I used them once.
Yep. Ghosts are cool. Not particularly useful, but they're cool.
So if Thalon energy burns you, are you basically just out of luck?
Yes.
Well, here he comes. Oh, here he is.
Oh, he went for you. I actually have no idea where he is, even in all... Like, I'm having trouble finding him. Oh, there he is. Ow.
I almost died. Is that your devastation or his?
This one's mine.
Okay. I can't see his mirror and all of your stuff.
Sorry. Doesn't matter, he's dead. It is better to level up in normal, but you can just play veteran if you want more stuff. And at a certain point, you'll probably get really bored of normal, and you can switch over to veteran to give yourself a bit more challenge.
Or you can be like me and just finish normal in 4 hours and then play elite.
Or you could just do that.
I haven't played veteran in ages. No idea what it's like.
It's like normal but slightly tankier enemies.
4 hours, indeed. Finished normal at level 36 to 37. Move into elite. Nice and fast.
I have to go back. That's like 2,000 iron.
Can't pass up on that. Isn't there like a broken wall here or something?
Is there?
Or a breakable wall? Oh, rest in peace, my friends.
Oh, yeah. Grimdawn looks great when it's a slideshow.
Hold mouse one.
W mouse one, pray. Well, you don't need to beat the game in 4 hours. It's just,
you know, it should take you like 20-ish hours if you're doing a regular playthrough and not just power.
Yeah, yeah. If you're just running through as fast as possible, it's like 4 hours. And there's nothing wrong with being around level 50 when you exit normal.
Yeah, like that's actually what you're supposed to be.
Yeah. Because you'll be able to equip legendaries then, and it makes your life a little easier.
Yeah. Plus elite starts around level 50.
Yeah. Oh, hey, the treasure trove.
Okay.
I clicked it trying to click on enemies.
All right, I draw it. 12,000 iron.
I got a manticore eye.
I got a bludge of... Refunding my skeleton key. And we didn't get a Vaudemon.
We didn't. Well then.
Well indeed. Good luck. Have fun. Why are they all grouped together? The melee person's not there.
Was there a hero in here?
There must have been, because something died.
Something died, we got the hero notification, and there's a burst of loot. Whoever...
He just, like, Zerg rushed down one of the bosses.
I thought you Zerg rushed down one of the bosses. Can't do that yet. Okay, there we go.
That's Aldrich. That's Carlos. Maybe.
That's all three.
Did you get the thing? Because I didn't.
I didn't.
Aw, shucks. See you at Melmoth.
Oh, there's a legendary. Oh, there's two legendaries.
I didn't get any.
No Voldaren.
What class works with soldier? All of them.
Except maybe Arcanist.
Yeah, except that, and maybe except Nightblade. We don't know.
Yeah, we're in debate. We're in debate over Blade Masters right now. Because I happen to... Huh? Yeah, I did.
I guess that means no flames in Malbuie.
Oh, whoops.
Just wasting a skeleton key. My skeleton key.
That was the one I got? Yeah, Arcanist is probably the only one that's kind of ho-hum right now. So Battle Mage combo. And we picked up a Grim Fate. So can he spawn in the... Can he spawn in the place with the Herald of Destruction?
I have no idea, but that would be really evil if he could.
Because otherwise he's probably in some weird... Just weird place.
Yeah.
Oh, he might... You know what? He might be in, the Hidden Lab on another level. Because we only really checked... The spot right outside the Warden's door and the, what do you call it? The spot in Underground Transit you can walk back to. I'm just selling off a bunch of stuff.
I'm willing to check. Does one shot just deal with level or area? Area. I just walked into a dead end. Spiders. Back in my day, people thought furies were overpowered.
Hey, I remember when Furies were scary. When you only have 40 levels to work with, they're scary.
Oh, you're just following in my footsteps.
Pretty much. I've given you your peace and quiet without all the devastations.
Well, I solidly have no idea where he is. Wait, how did you get up there?
I walked.
Kind of just happened. The shield you have? What shield do you have?
Me?
Yeah.
It's Ascandra's... It's Ascandra's set piece. Ascandra's text. Not a shield, technically. But that's what I'm using. Unless he's to, like, your left. I don't know where he'd be.
Yeah, I was thinking of that. This is one of the Aether Crystals over here.
Nope. Doesn't look like he's in here.
No.
Man, we pretty much did the whole lab.
Can he still show up on Hallowed Hill?
Can he? Has he ever been able to show up there?
I have no idea. I thought he used to be able to.
Well. Oh, gotta follow. Hello, Nemesis Pepe. Thanks for the follow.
What a name. I just can't think of where else he would be.
I know, it's weird. He's usually one of the easy ones.
Guess I'll check out Planes of Strife.
If he can appear there, that would suck. Just outright suck.
Look at all of these enemies I have no interest in fighting. Goodbye, fame, mate.
I'm not even there and it's causing your frame rate troubles.
It's better in the hotfix. The hotfix is amazing for performance.
Well, that's good. I should just show up in Planes of Strife while you're wandering around. Just do things. Devastations.
Knock me down to 2 FPS. Found a lot of spear. It's kind of the same thing, right? Can I solo 2-player difficulty lot spear?
If you can't open a portal, I'll come over there and get the
I opened one.
Drop.
I think I'm okay.
Well, I want the drop too, so. Pure greed. I didn't see who followed, but thank you. Oh. Wildblood Mantle. I'll take it. Back to Hallowed.
If you want the drop. A lot of frostburn damage.
That is a lot of frostburn damage. No, you can keep it. Back to the hill I go. Yeah, speaking of monster frequence, there should really be one on Hallowed Hill.
Yeah, seriously. I feel like every time I'm there, I say that. Have we checked the armory? No.
Oh, yeah. He could be in there. Hey, Sirach. Valdaren is actually not that annoying. We're just having a hard.
You, I think he's so
really?
Annoying. Yeah.
I always find him when I don't want to find him, and I always find him when I do want to find him.
How does that not annoy you?
But I always find him when I do want to find him. So. Yeah, I actually don't find him annoying at all. Ben Jar is the really annoying one, and we found him just randomly while looking for Valderin. I will open this treasure trove.
Opponents, save them. Save components.
You save your components, and you always pick up your minor components. Do you want me to open a portal? Well, I opened a portal, but do you want to come and get this treasure trove with me?
Oh, sure. As soon as I slay this hero. Where are you?
Hallowed Hill.
Okay.
It's kind of a reason to come here, I guess.
Blood of Krathan is a pretty good reason.
Okay, then.
You can use components for crafting, that's the main thing.
Okay, that's a pretty funny portal from you.
What?
Warped in and there's a Flesh Hulk right there.
That's the Grim Dawn in a nutshell portal.
Yeah, you mostly want to keep them for crafting. Like, the one you don't realize you need a lot of is, like, Searing Ember.
Searing Ember and Polished Emerald, so...
Yep.
You need hundreds of those.
I think it's... Is Scavenge Plate the other thing that goes into Dynamite?
Yeah.
Because you use
the... Scavenge Plating drops from literally everything.
Yeah, so. That's true. So, yeah, you need Scavenge Plating, Searing Emeralds for Dynamite. Polished Emeralds go for Legendary Crafting at the Legendary Crafter.
Why couldn't this be on a monster infrequent? Yeah, you have fun up there.
What's a good stat distribution for a conjurer?
Physique.
That's pretty much my answer too. Maybe a little spirit, but mostly physique.
Maybe like 10 spirit-ish, and then 80 physique. 10 to 15 spirit.
Yeah, the only build I can think of where you want to actually invest in, like, not physique, is this one. Just because you need so much energy regen to manage Albrecht's Aether, right? And even then, you could probably get away with 2-to-1 physique spirit.
Alright, who suggested the armory?
I don't know, some jerk. And doesn't look like he was here either.
Maybe Nemesis just aren't a thing. Should check the patch notes. Deleted Nemesis.
He's a non-assist now? A never-assist?
I got really scared by that devastation he was about to cast.
That was actually kind of a dramatic death on his part.
Yeah. We're good. More health potions.
Yes, it will still count towards the quests.
Because I only have 700 health potions.
Let's see. Where would he be? I mean, the only place I can think of that's left is, like, the far west spawn point, Rotting Croplands.
Did you check, like, everywhere in the Necropolis?
No, he just has 2 spots in it. It's one to the right, one to the left.
Okay.
I mean, you can run around it more if you want.
Not particularly.
This stream greater than the Grim Dawn Wiki. Well, considering the 2 people you've got here, probably. Like, what? If we got a dev in here, we'd probably be extremely greater than the Grim Dawn Wiki.
The devs don't know anything. But don't tell them I said that.
I reset the game.
Or did you?
Yeah, I did.
I am checking immolation because it totally isn't painful to get to.
Yeah, that's the last thing to check because he's not to the left. He's not at the west spawn point in Rotting Croplands. Because, yeah, he can pop up right there, which we looked at. Right there, which I always looked at. And right there.
Why am I checking immolation? You have.
Yeah, I should be the one doing that. Here, open a portal.
Alright. Portal open.
Alright, let's see what I'm surrounded by here.
No, you're fine.
Oh, okay, we're right here. Okay, I'll run through.
Dicky Dick. Dan's game.
Yeah, he's shown up in the stream once for me.
Once.
Maybe twice.
Well, in his defense, he's way over in Europe, which, you know, who lives there?
I know, right? It's not like half my chat is German.
Stupid, annoying yellow gear. Depends on your level. If you're above level 30, no. Valdoran just doesn't exist.
Nope. He's deleted from the game.
Yep. Heard it here first, folks. I almost just died.
Plague Bearer of Dreeg.
Nothing of interest.
Yeah, yellow gear after you've pretty much gotten everything geared out on your character is ignorable. It isn't. Like, once you start getting a lot of greens and your character's fully kitted out with those, you can pretty much ignore them.
With the exception of attack and of vitality.
Yes. But those can drop on greens too, so.
Yeah. Are you still looking for Valdoran? Because I've moved on in life. Nether crystals.
I'm checking one weird spot. Oh, you know what? Can he spawn an Astrakarn?
I'm pretty sure he can't.
Okay.
But maybe he can. How have I gone without dying so far? Oh, maybe just changed it.
I was kind of hoping you'd die right there. Yeah, and endgame stuff is all greens and purples. Some blues, Some blues are still good.
Oh. I kind of forgot to reactivate all my buffs after the Locksmith fight.
That was me slapping my forehead.
Just wandering around the Immolation with no buffs. Seems good.
Hmm. Yeah, we checked the Necropolis, the two spawn points there.
I have a vague idea.
I'm gonna... No, just Valdarin spawn points. We've come to this.
You have no idea how many times I've searched for that.
Let's see. Burial Cave, Burwich Village. Warden Cellar, Underground Transit, Hidden Lab, Rotting Croplands, Gruesome Harvest, Plains of Strife, Astrakhan Road, Armory, Necropolis, Conflagration. So we can, apparently, according to the wiki, spawn in Astrakhan.
Alrighty then.
That's the first time I've had to do that for him.
Oh, why hello there. He's not down in the center. Which seems like the obvious place to put him.
You would think.
Confused overmines with nemesis chests way too often. Joe Dredd. And he's gone.
Yep.
He was kind enough to give me a shoulder guards of justice, so.
There you go.
Appreciate it.
The Sylph necklaces are. So in Whitemire. Here, I'll just go there real quick. Yeah, we have to go through the entirety of the map. So, Whitemire Riftgate, you run up this direction, and you go around a little corner up a hill, and there's going to be these guys here. That's where you go turn that quest in.
So, I have a question.
Shoot.
Since when can you knock down Yetis?
What?
I just blitzed into a Yeti and knocked him down.
You can knock down Yetis? This changes everything.
Time to pick up that transmuter for Calidor's Tempest.
Exactly. Did I just get what I think I just got?
I don't know, did you?
Oh, it's... I thought I got a chilled Yeti's Horn of Death's Chill. And it was a chipped Yeti horn of Death's Chill.
I might be dead.
I'm coming.
No, I might actually be A-OK. Also, no, you cannot knock down Yetis, but you can knock down Yeti heroes. Because heroes, for some reason, have lesser resistance.
Is that sort of like how you can freeze Flesh Hulk heroes?
Yeah.
But you can't freeze Flesh Hulks?
Because reasons.
Yes.
I am growing perturbed.
Yeah, this is actually, like, a little on the annoying side now.
Nice, I got him to admit it.
Yeah, Sino did earlier.
Yeah, he's not in burial. What in the world is a CR0?
I don't even know what that is. A crow?
Dank cellar. Sounds pretty dank to me.
Oh, that one cellar.
Is that in Burwich Village?
Yeah, that one. Oh, here we go. We'll clear out this game one way or another to find a Valdaren spawn.
I've been tempted to do, like, a, clearing the whole map stream at some point. But I feel like it would just take forever.
This would be the flooded cellar, not the dank cellar.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming along, Raiden. Cellar. Glad to have you on the stream. No, I don't know that.
I feel like I heard that story once upon a time.
See, the thing about the dank cellar is I don't actually think I've been in there. Where in the hell's the entrance?
Is it the one where, the inventor person is?
Is that the dank one? Yeah, because this is infested.
I see you haven't dealt with Harvey the Drifter yet.
Nope. Just leaving him to hang around.
Yeah.
See, I would... Normally, if I were single playering this, I wouldn't bother looking in all these weird spots. I'd just be out of here already. But because we're doing multi, it's like it's just a little more difficult to reset the game.
Is indeed the dankest of cellars.
Yeah, this is where Grim Dawn produces all of its dank memes.
Well, apparently, Valdaren is not a meme lover.
No. Oh, that's so close to being a thing. If that was Tyrants of Alacrity instead of Clarity, or that attack speed.
But Force Wave, though. So you get that, and I get this.
Open up group menu, select Sino, hit ban.